Let's bring in Kevin, who is a Celtic fan from Bishop Briggs. Kevin, how would you sum up how you're feeling as a Celtic fan this evening?
Good evening, panel. Well, what to describe it? Absolutely heartbroken. Absolutely heartbroken with what's happening at my club just now. Something's got to change. It's a nightmare to watch. You're dreading every game that's coming up, every tie. You don't know what team's going to turn up. Celtic's my life. It's everything I'm about. I go home, I'm away. I've been on my social media screaming 10 in a row for years. Rangers have been to the bottom tier of Scottish football and they're back and 10 in a row's done. The dream's done. It's out the window. The dream's finished. We've got t-shirts made, we've got flags made. We've been singing 10 in a row for years and now it's out the window. I don't know, I'm lucky for the boys. A lot of my friends, Rangers supporters, friends on social media, and it's relentless, it's back and forward, and it's just didn't expect this to happen. I don't know what the panel's thoughts on that, what their thoughts on that.
Didn't expect it to happen is that is the understatement of the year, isn't it? Because I mean, you can win and lose titles. Everyone had Celtic, you know, very much favourites to win. But you know what? If they had been a little bit off it, or the pressure, or people recruitment not quite right, and Rangers, because by the way, Rangers are absolutely flying. So you know you can't take that away. Rangers are not going to win this league all because Celtic have capitulated. Rangers are going to win it because they've also been relentless.
Listen,
but the way
I'll take you back to the 1st of August. Were you at Pittodrie, Daz? Aberdeen 0, Rangers 1.
No,
trying to think. 1st of August anyway.
Was it?
And
no.
we do the predictions.
I can't remember where it was this morning.
That's true. We do the predictions at the start of the season, and there was the usual chant that, you know, Celtic are favourites to win the league, to get 10 in a row. And you know, the argument was, well, 10 in a row has never been done before. You know, you were a fancy Celtic in the 70s, Rangers in the 90s, they didn't do it. So there would be a counter argument that yes, this Rangers team had the potential to go and win the championship this season. But if you had said that day in the 1st of August, they would be sitting here in the middle of January and Rangers would be 21 points clear, having dropped only 4 points all season, having conceded only 6 league goals all season, and that Celtic would have, you know, dropped points at home at Hibs on a Monday night and fallen effectively, even if they win their 3 games in hand, they're still 12 points adrift.
With the goal difference as well, so you're
with a goal difference, I think the difference is something like 23 goals or something like that, Gordon. No one would have believed it. I wouldn't have believed it. Daz wouldn't have believed it. You know, Kevin wouldn't have believed it. This has been one of the most unpredictable seasons I can ever remember.
Kevin, you say, you know, it's broken your heart. At what point did that finally break? At what point did you give up the 10 in a row dream?
Old Firm game in the second. Any time you get beat after Rangers, it's heartbreaking, but to lose that game the way we did, Rangers not even having a shot on target, you've got to take your hat off. The Rangers have been absolutely outstanding this season. I mean, there's Celtic fans out there who will start and say Rangers are this and Rangers are that. They're no Celtic fans there, but they're Celtic glasses after 5 minutes and just realise that this is the first challenge we've really, really had and we've failed. And we can only really blame ourselves. If you look at the board, look, the amount of money that Celtic's put in over the years while Rangers were rebuilding, and we've brought in this X amount of money for this player and that player, and the money's not been getting spent. We've just been expecting 10 in a row to happen because there was no challenge. See, Rangers have brought in Steven Gerrard, and the miracles that guy's worked in the last couple of years, given he's not got any trophies so far, but he's just won the league. He's just stopped 10 in a row. He's going to go down in history as a Rangers legend.
Kevin, it's not just the board that thought it would happen. Obviously, supporters, and you're one. I just hope you get the receipt for your T-shirts, get your money back. But I think it's the way that it's unfolded this season, Gordon. You know, Rangers were always going to be a threat. Did we think they were going to win it by January? Absolutely not. I don't even think, you know, the Rangers fans thought that. As much as you've got to congratulate Rangers, they've been absolutely brilliant. It's there for everyone to see. The points, the goals against, the goals for, the way they're playing. They've beaten Celtic twice in the league. For Celtic, for some reason, it has just every single thing, every decision this season has went completely wrong for them. And I do believe that, you know, there's a big divide now. There's a big job at Celtic because you've got to bring the supporters and the club back together. There's a big divide now. Celtic fans are not happy. And you can, everybody's throwing Dubai into it. Yes, that's a major, major part. The fact that they're so far behind Rangers, the way they've been playing, the signings, the way that, you know, things have happened at the club. So there's a big rebuilding job at Celtic. And I honestly believe it's got to start now. Don't wait till the summer.
What would you do next, Kevin? As a supporter, what would you do?
Yeah, just like your panel said, I reckon we've got to start now. We've got to... Neil Lennon has got to go. As much as he's done what he's done for us, that's all in the past now. Then treble, whatever. That means nothing. But that's all in the past. We were going for 10 in a row. You need to understand the magnitude of this. This was enormous. This was the Holy Grail, like we've all been saying. And it's in tatters, absolute tatters. And I'm in tatters. I just, my heart is broken. Celtic has broke my heart. And you're like it's a hard pill to swallow, I'll tell you.
Kevin, you're doing
okay. Honestly, that's what football does to you. Kevin, please look after yourself. You sound heartbroken.